Hello, David Zaritsky for the Bond Experience. Welcome back. I am joined here by my son, Ellis. How you doing, Ellis?
Hey, I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing really good. So some of you may recognize Ellis from a couple other things. First of all, Olivar Brown, you did a review, didn't you?
Yeah.
Of a shirt,
I did.
Sunglasses.
And I still have them, and I still wear them today.
That's right. And you also did a, I think you did a holiday video with us.
Mm-hmm.
As well?
The sweater, and I was also Q.
And I was going to hit that last, but yes, you were Q in the Aston Martin video as well. And then you did Roger Moore. You saw the Roger Moore films. So you've been in a bunch of these, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you probably recognize Ellis, but I figured we would take an opportunity because we talk a lot about James Bond and the Bond community, but I keep hearing from executives that this new James Bond coming up is not going to be your father's Bond, whatever that means. So I figured I'd pick your brain a little bit.
Great.
You're not a millennial.
No.
What do you consider?
I just made the cut.
Gen
of,
Y?
Gen Z. No.
Gen Z.
Yes.
It's the I... What is it? The
iGen.
iGen.
Gen Z.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Centennials.
All right. So what do you know about James Bond?
Oh, gosh. Not as much as you.
Well, I hope not.
Definitely more than the average Gen Z person.
Is it because it's been thrusted upon you?
Yeah. Well, I do actually really enjoy some, I'm going to say, Bond films.
Okay.
Not all of them.
Which ones don't you enjoy?
Oh, no. I'm going to get in trouble.
No. That's okay. We'll ship you out of town.
Oh, gosh. What was the one...
Who was the star in it? Who was
Daniel Craig?
Oh no, that's fine. Was it Quantum? Was it?
Yeah. Well, Quantum was okay. It was the most. Oh, Spectre.
Spectre.
Spectre. I was not a fan of Spectre.
Yeah, no. A lot of people feel that way about Spectre. What didn't you like about it?
Well, I'm a huge movie buff. I mean, I went to school or went to college for film, and it just killed me. The plot killed me. Even some of the acting, because there were great actors in it.
Yeah.
And I was like, what's going on?
It's kind of meh.
It's not. Yeah, it was kind of meh for me.
Yeah, I get it.
It wasn't terrible.
What's your favorite James Bond film? One that's like, oh.
Octopussy, no doubt.
Wow.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you like Roger Moore a lot.
I love Roger Moore.
Yeah.
My favorite Bond.
There's a reason why we set up this stage in front of the Roger Moore stuff. It's because you love Roger Moore.
I do.
Now, what do you like about Roger Moore's characterization of James Bond?
He's fun. I mean, he was fun, and, you know, I like Sean Connery, too, but I think that Roger Moore just had a more natural, you know, Bond flair to him.
Yeah.
He was very classic, and he was just easy to like.
Yes.
He was just a likable guy. And I feel like for some Bonds, you know, like Pierce Brosnan, for example, it's a little harder because he was just, you know, so much of a womanizer where it was like overboard. And I was like, all right, calm down. You know, this isn't Mamma Mia, so...
Wow, you just took the Mickey right out of Brosnan.
Yeah,
I like that.
Sorry.
All right, so I think the audience realizes that you've seen Bond in a lot of different roles. The 70s, the 80s, the 90s, and now. So, I mean, there's so much going on right now where people say Bond isn't ready for the Me Too movement. It's not ready for who we are as a society. I mean, what are your thoughts on that?
Oh, wow, wow.
It's a big question.
Yeah, I mean, to your point, I mean, Bond has been around for a long time. It's seen a lot of wear and tear through the years.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I do think that they've done a good job of kind of molding it into the current generation, you know, bringing in more, you know, lead females who aren't just there for their face and their body. They're there because they're, like, secret agents and things like that. Like, they're doing better with that, I think. They could do even better.
That's fine. Don't be apologetic for it.
Yeah, I mean, I've heard some rumors.
What rumors have you heard?
That there's going to be a little bit more LGBT representation. Or I should say, there is going to be LGBT representation. There really hasn't been any.
Right.
That I recall.
Right, right.
Ever. Which is kind of a...
There has. There were two bad guys from Diamonds Are Forever who were gay.
Oh, okay.
Homosexual?
My bad.
No, it's fine.
But, okay, so, I mean, to that point, I didn't even know.
Yeah.
I mean, that's...
I mean, Bond's been pretty good about evolving things into the community.
Mm-hmm.
I think one of the things that people... I'll tell you what people seem to be up in arms about is they're like, you know what? You can change characters. You can have representation. You can have all this. Don't change our James Bond. Mm-hmm. Like, make James Bond a misogynistic womanizer because he does that as part of his job.
Yeah.
You know, he's a spy and assassin. He's not supposed to be a good guy.
Right. And I used to hate that. And I used to complain about that to you. Yes. I used to be like, why is James Bond still doing this stuff? Like, it's 2019. What's going on? But as I thought about it, I was like, James Bond isn't the guy that you want to be all the time. It's just, you know, he's got these cool aspects. You know, he's fashionable, all this other stuff. But it's like Thanos. Thanos, that's a horrible
keep
comparison.
Keep going.
But, like, I like Thanos because he's an asshole. I mean, he wants to destroy half the planet.
Right.
But there are moments where you're like, oh, man, this, you know, I kind of get where he's coming from. But that was a horrible comparison.
No, that was very funny. And I've heard worse comparisons before, believe me.
But, I mean, he's not, you know, this god. I mean, he's not perfect. You see in every single Bond movie that he has a lot of flaws.
Yeah.
And that's a flaw. And they don't make this, like, this grand thing where he's like, oh, he gets to sleep with all the women he likes. Those women sometimes die.
Yeah.
And those women sometimes stab him in the back. And, you know, so it's not a perfect situation for a womanizer.
And it's a dark thing. He's not a Marvel superhero. He's not Captain America. There should be dark moments. All right. So you're 27? How old are you? 28? 23. That's what I said. 23. I knew that.
Cut that out.
Actually, it was 24. No, we're not cutting anything out.
No.
So you're 26. You're 23. I'm kidding. You're 23 years old. So I have a question for you. 23-year-olds, your friends, when they watch a Bond film, do they get excited about a Bond film coming out? Could they care less? I mean, be totally honest. Don't worry about who's watching this. Like, is it a non-event
for that age group? Don't have one friend that I've talked about a James Bond film with.
Yeah.
And all of my friends are total nerds. I mean, they watch all the DC films, Marvel, they read comic books, everything like that. Not one of my friends has talked to me about a Bond film.
So what do you think it is? Do you think it's not adhering to that generation? Is it just not their cup of tea? Like will your friends watch Fast and the Furious and action films and things like that?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, mostly it's a joke. I mean, no one really watches the Fast and Furious for, you know,
For good car movements.
Yeah.
So what do you think it is?
I don't know. I mean, honestly, that's something I've thought about, too, because whenever I've brought a friend or a girl over the house, they're like, oh, yeah, I've never seen a Bond film.
They'll, like, walk around here, like, what the hell?
Or, oh, I think I've seen Casino Royale, and it's like, okay, well, it's a good one to watch. But, I mean, it's kind of a shame, I mean, because there are a lot of Bond films that are really awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, Moonraker is a great one to watch.
It is.
For someone my age, because it's just fun.
Yeah.
But, yeah, most of them, no.
There's a YouTuber, young compared to me, who's actually very influential on YouTube in the Bond community, named Calvin Dyson, and his favorite Bond film is Moonraker.
Yeah.
He petitions for it all the time, and he actually learned about James Bond through the video games. He didn't learn about him through the... Then all of a sudden, somebody was like, wait, you know, there's movies on this.
And yeah.
What?
Well, that's the other thing is, like, my friends are very much into video game culture as well, and they've all heard of GoldenEye.
Right.
You know, the famous glitches and everything like that. So, I mean, through video games, I mean, Bond's in everything.
Yeah.
He's everywhere, you know, you go.
Right. Put on your producer cap. If you were the producer or the distributors, you know, United Artists or MGM or Universal, because there's a lot of people distributing Bond, and you said, I need to connect with people in their 20s and teens. What would you do differently with James Bond?
Nothing. I would do absolutely nothing. So something that gets on my nerves and pretty much everybody else's nerves is when movie producers or the people advertising for those movies try too hard.
Yeah.
What happens is we look at that and we're like, what are you trying to do? Like, you're trying to be one of us. And sometimes they'll even hire people my age and it's just totally backfires.
Yeah.
Probably another horrible example again, but Wendy's. Wendy's has someone.
The hamburger people?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah. They have someone to run their Twitter account, and, you know, a lot of people might think it's funny and whatever else, but a lot of people my age are just kind of like, oh, they're trying too hard.
So it backfires significantly.
Yeah. To me, I think it backfires. But, you know, to other people, they might like that. But when they try to bring, like, the meme culture, like, a little too hard into movies and things like that, it just totally backfires.
You can see through it.
Yeah.
I think that's part of the thing. So I think why people are getting frustrated right now, even with all the rumors, is it's like, if they are doing these things as plot points, it almost seems like they're trying too hard. Mm-hmm. They're inserting it where people just, honestly, they just want a good Bond adventure. Mm-hmm. You know, they want it to be complete. Spectre was a miss, you know, in some aspects. And they're like, all right, now you have a second chance.
Yeah. And I mean, you know, Bond films aren't for everybody.
No.
They're never going to be for everybody. That's almost impossible unless you're a Disney movie.
Right.
So, and it's not a Disney movie. It's not an animated feature where it's mostly for kids, but then you throw some adult jokes in there. It's never been like that, and it never should be like that.
Do you think your age group would enjoy Bond more if it was a young actor, like low 30s, you know, a 31-year-old, 32-year-old versus a 51-year-old right now?
Probably, yeah. Yeah, I think that would probably have a wider audience involved in it. But then again, I mean, there's, like the Jumanji movies, the newer ones, you know, it's older actors in it. I mean,
people gravitate to it.
Yeah. And people like it. People my age love it. But again, that's a comedy. That's a funny, fun film.
Do people your age like Mission Impossible movies more than Bond movies?
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Really?
For sure. Yeah.
Now why
but
is
that's
that?
Also because, I mean, those aren't as old.
No, they're not.
I mean,
that's true.
They started, you know, probably right when I was born.
So it was part of your upbringing.
Yeah. We kind of grew up with it. Like, the Mission Impossible theme is, like, a classic.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I do know people that are like, oh, like, new Mission Impossible movie, you know. So.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
All right. So let's turn it around a little bit. You know Bond very well. Obviously, a lot of your friends don't know Bond that well. What are the things that you think some of your age group could learn from watching the James Bond films?
How to dress properly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You almost needed to say that.
I needed to say that. Yeah. Fashion. Definitely not how to treat people.
Yeah.
Not conversational skills.
Right.
There's a lot of things you can learn not to do.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
But again, like, it's so obvious.
So more of the stylistic stuff.
Yeah.
Things like that.
Yeah. Cars, you know. But yeah, in a lot of the Bond movies, I mean, it's just obvious. You know, he's not meant to be a perfect specimen. He's not Harry Potter.
Right.
You know.
He's an anti-hero.
Yeah, he absolutely.
I mean,
he absolutely is.
He falls within that category as opposed to the true heroes that you want them to emulate and act in the purest form. Mm-hmm. Anti-heroes, you want them to be tainted.
Right, and that's what makes him interesting. That's what makes him such a prominent figure throughout movie history is that he's not perfect.
Yeah.
He's never been perfect. Never will be.
All right. So here's a cheat question that most people your age could not answer.
Uh-oh.
But you can because you've been kind of brought and raised by osmosis with this crazy stuff. And that is, you saw Spectre. You didn't enjoy it. What are you hoping to see in the new Bond film? Even throw out a plot point if you want.
Well, I'm hoping to see gadgets.
Gadgets are always
those
fun.
Have been lacking.
Yeah,
from my point of view.
Yeah,
I love the gadgets. I'm hoping to see a good car chase.
Yeah, good car chase. Because the Spectre one was not good. It just wasn't.
You need a good car chase or two.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know much about the new film. I know what you've told me.
Yeah, yeah.
And
so you're gonna kind of go in a little bit surprised, which is good.
Mm-hmm. I try to for most films.
That's good.
Yeah, I mean, that's all I can really say. That's all I can really hope for.
No, that's good.
Obviously, plot.
A good story and good characters.
Yeah.
Yeah. I always feel like a good bad guy is essential.
Mm-hmm.
Rami Malek, you a fan of his?
I can't not be, yeah.
Yeah. Did you see Rhapsody?
I haven't
Bohemian
seen it.
Rhapsody?
No.
It's actually good.
Yeah.
It's really good. But Anyway, it'll be fun. All right.
Like Queen too much.
Yeah.
To actually watch
it. You think they destroyed the film?
No, I don't think so. I just, you know, people watch it once and then they're Queen fans forever. So
I totally get it. Well, first of all, thank you. Thanks for your opinion. I think a lot of people, you know, were interested. We usually, so these groups, they get together and it's usually, you know, these kind of older guys talking about Bond, but I definitely wanted to get a different perspective. This was not rehearsed. You did not get the questions ahead of time. Mm-mm. I just gave you kind of a higher level, like what this was going to be about. Nothing else. You were not paid for this.
What?
You will not be paid for this.
No.
There's no remuneration. You're not sponsored by anyone yet.
Oh.
No. It's so sad. It's getting sadder in here. No, but thank you for doing this.
Yeah.
Appreciate it. Yeah. And this has been David Zaritsky and Ella Zaritsky for the Bond Experience. We will see you all very soon. Take care.
Oh.
Thanks for watching this episode. If you want to be up on the latest from the Bond Experience, just click on this subscribe and subscribe to our channel. You're going to get all the latest and greatest information, plus some exclusive content. And by the way, speaking of content, here's something especially for you, just because we know you. Talk to you soon.